Good evening, one and all. Today in this session we will be discussing about the heart attack and its preventive measures. Nowadays the incidence of heart attack is increasing, especially in younger population, as it also the morbidity, that is mortality, the number of people dying of heart attack is increasing. So we will be discussing what is heart attack and how can we prevent it, and what is its general management. Okay, in brief we will be discussing. See, heart is nothing but a cardiac muscle, we call it as myocardium. So it will be keep on contracting and relaxing, so that it requires a continuous supply of oxygen. Okay, so that if the heart functions very well, the blood will be pumped out of the heart to supply the nutrients, oxygen to the entire body. So whenever there is a supply demand mismatch, we will call it as, that is decrease in the oxygen levels supplied to the heart, with either could be because of, there are many reasons, the main predominantly is a occlusion of the vessels supplying the heart, that is the vessels which are supplying the heart will be get blocked, so that the oxygen supply will be diminished, so that then the patient will get heart attack. So what is the cause for the blockage, or the blockage of the blood vessels to the heart? We'll call it as a coronaries. Coronary vessels will supply blood to the heart. So the main cause is atherosclerosis, we'll call it as. Atherosclerosis is nothing but deposition of cholesterol in the walls of the coronaries. So if it keeps on building up the in the vessel walls, if the cholesterol keeps on building up, ultimately the lumen will get blocked, and ultimately the patient will develop heart attack. One more cause could be rupture of these plaques, which are situated subintimally in the vessel walls, then also the patient can have heart attack. So how the patient presents, or the what are the symptoms of heart attack? Majority, there are many symptoms of heart attack. The majority of the patients will have what is called as chest pain. Okay, it can be it is very subjective to the different patients. Okay, some patients will complain of chest pain, or it could be tightness or squeezing type of chest pain. Okay, and also sometimes they will complain of this chest pain can be radiating to up to the jaw or the left hand, sometimes on the upper abdomen also. Very few patients will not have a chest pain. They will have other symptoms like shortness of breath, or giddiness, or some reeling sensation. These are the very rare symptoms, but the majority of the patients will complain of chest pain, that is typical chest pain, that is, which is central chest pain, which can be radiating to the upper jaw, up to the jaw, or left hand, or into the abdomen. Okay, so how to evaluate these patients? If somebody comes to with these symptoms, we need to be confirmed whether the patient is having a heart attack or not, which can be done with the help of 2D echocardiogram. Initially we'll do a electrocardiogram, that is ECG, followed by a 2D echocardiogram, and also we'll do what is called as cardiac enzymes, troponins, CKMB, so which will confirm whether the patient is having a heart attack or not. Some other investigations also can be done, but these are the three important investigations done to confirm the patient, whether the patient is having a heart attack or not. That is ECG, 2D echocardiogram, and cardiac enzymes. If the patient is found to have a heart attack with the help of these investigations, next step is how to manage these patients. The patients can be managed whether medically or surgically. Before deciding whether the patient is to be managed medically or surgically, we need to do angiogram, what we will call as coronary angiogram. In coronary angiogram, what we will do is, we will be imaging the blood vessels, that is coronaries, which are supplying to the heart. Okay, if you find any blocks or any other like dissections or something, which can be managed with percutaneously, that is percutaneous coronary intervention, we will call it as. Okay, if it is manageable with percutaneously, we got as percutaneous coronary intervention, which can be done with the help of stents, okay, or balloons. Okay, if the patient is, depending on the severity, if the patient is having very severe disease, anatomic, that is triple vessel disease, which are not amenable for percutaneous coronary intervention, will be managing with what is called as coronary artery bypass grafting, which is surgical management of heart attack. Okay, once the patient managed with these, whether some patients will not have a obstructions or blocks in the coronaries, those will be managed with the only tablets, that is medications itself. Okay. So this is in brief how to manage these patients. So what are all the preventive measures? How can we prevent the heart attack from occurring? Okay. So very important is, so once somebody develops a heart attack, that is in the form of either chest pain, shortness of breath or any other symptom, what you need to remember is the importance of reaching a hospital in time. See, the more the time you waste in the opening of the vessel, the important goal of all the medical management or surgical management is to open up the vessel which was blocked, to open up the vessel as early as possible, either with the medications or with the help of percutaneous coronary intervention. Okay, with these two modalities will be helpful to open up the vessel. So the importance of reaching a hospital within 6 hours. Okay, so the moment somebody develops a chest pain or heart attack, okay, so reach early an airway hospital, confirm the diagnosis, okay, and it should be so that you can be managed early and you can have a good results when compared with late presentation. Okay, the more the time you delay reaching a hospital, the more the complications and the more the damage to the heart. Okay, so the recovery also will be delayed. So reach a hospital in time, so and you can be managed. Regular physical activity, so it's very, very important. It has many, many impacts on the prevention of atherosclerosis in broad spectrum. That is, atherosclerosis can occur at the brain or at the heart or at the peripheral vessels. Okay, so with all these locations, if you do a regular physical activity, we can minimize the deposition of atherosclerosis plaques. Okay, so how to prevent it? So if you walk for at least 2.5 hours of regular, that is moderate intensity physical activity in a week, that is 2.5 hours. That is, if you are manageable to walk for at least 2.5 hours in a week, that is sufficient. Suppose if somebody is unable to manage this, if you do strenuous exercises like weightlifting, all those strenuous exercises, if you are able to do at least 1.5 hour of strenuous exercise, that is also sufficient for 1 week. So the more commonly suggestible is 30 minutes daily walk at the rate of 6 kilometers per hour. If you are able to manage this, then definitely the chances of occurring all these complications will be minimized. The second is diet. Okay, so diet also plays very important role. Okay, so the concept of the balanced diet is very, very important. You need to take all the diet, all the nutrients, but in a limited manner, and which are it's not like micronutrients concept has been, I think it is nowadays nobody's preferring it. Okay, avoiding some nutrients, taking preferably only these much nutrients. So rather than that, you go for a balanced diet. You take all the nutrients in a balanced manner. Okay, and also those are having, suppose, risk factors like hypertension, diabetes, okay, dyslipidemia, those patients need to consult a doctor and take regular medications, and you need to effectively manage all these comorbidities which are risk factors for development of heart attack. And also habits, okay, so like smoking and alcohol intake should be stopped. Okay, so those are the majority of the, in younger generation, those are developing heart attack within less than 40 years. The main risk factors for them is either like smoking, drinking, or the dyslipidemias. Okay, so these are gaining some importance in the younger generations. Those are developing early heart attacks. So be healthy and stay healthy. So and you can lead a good life. Thank you.